Welcome in the video on the poem Hiroshima, written by great Hindi poet Agyei. I am Dr. Vinita Bhadauria, Associate Professor of English in Government College, Behar Road. This poem is prescribed in the BA final year of RRBM University, Paper 1. Poetry and Drama of English Literature. Hiroshima is a modern poem by S.H. Vatsyayan Agyei. It deals with the humanistic and socialistic leanings of the poet towards the miserable plight of the innocent people of Hiroshima, a city of Japan where the atom bomb was dropped by America. Originally, this poem was written in Hindi and was later on it was translated from Hindi to English by Agyei himself and Leonard Nathan. Agyei was a student of science. He got regular education in the study of atom, how radioactive storm atom affect people, and studied all this till one day atomic fission took place in the world. He had theoretical knowledge of radioactivity and its effect on humanity and other living beings. When an atom bomb was dropped on Hiroshima on 6th August 1945, he was in close touch with the news and its side effects. He was greatly disturbed in mind and wrote a few articles but did not compose a poem about it. He had some experience of seeing some action of war when he was a journalist on the eastern frontier of India. After that, Agyei got an opportunity of going to Japan. There he went to Hiroshima also and saw in the hospital and patients lying there for years and suffering untold pain due to radioactivity. Thus, he got practical experience which led to deep sympathy. He did not compose a poem then and there. He did not write anything even after seeing all this in Hiroshima. The bomb killed or seriously wounded 160,000 people. Then he came across a signed stone having some bright shadow on it. He thought that some vehicle might have stood there at the time of explosion. The people in the vehicle were changed into ashes. This is how Agyei saw the atomic tragedy written on that burnt stone. He felt as if he had seen the atomic explosion with his own eye. Then all of a sudden he composed this poem, Hiroshima, not in Japan, but sitting in a train after returning to India. So this is a brief background how the poem was written. It also shows the brutality of human being, the unwanted carnage caused by the haughty and self-centered politicians, the horrible and incredible human brutality and butchery against humanity. In technique and style, the poem has modern tone and temper, full of hard and solid images, which remind us of T.S. Eliot, Ezra Pound, Hopkins, and Auden, and other war poets. In order to understand the poem, one should go to the background of the history related to the bombardment of America on the two important cities of Japan, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, during the Second World War. So, I have given you a brief background what has happened in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the city of Japan. Now the poem, Hiroshima, its analysis and explanation. On this day, the sun appeared not slowly over the horizon, but right in the city square. A blast of dazzle powered over, not from the middle sky, but from the earth torn raggedly open. Few meanings. Horizon means the line at which the earth and the sky appear to meet. In Hindi we call it kshitij, blast, a wave of air from an explosion. Dazzle, bright light that can blinds temporarily. Very bright light. Raggedly, badly torn or tattered into small pieces. In Hindi we can say chitre chitre ho jana. Dazed, confused and bewildered, unable to react properly. Pitched, moved suddenly. So Age wrote this poem, as I told you, after a visit to Japan, where he saw with his own eyes the devastating effect of the bomb on the city Hiroshima. He visited the hospitals there and saw the people suffering from the effects of radioactivity years later. Here poet says and gives a factual account of the atom bomb dropping on Hiroshima in Japan, and gives a poetic account of its destabilizing effect on the city and its inhabitants. On 6th August 1945, the Sun is the name given to that bright atom bomb, appeared not from the eastern sky, because that is not sun, that is the poetic name given for the atom bomb, but right in the city square, from the earth torn, ragged open. It means a bomb blast on the earth in the noon hours in the city square of Hiroshima, and left the people into pieces. Human. In these lines, the poet has given a graphic description of the great devastation caused by the atom bomb. The poet has compared the atom bomb with the sun. The sun rises in the eastern sky, but the bomb rose right in the city square. The poet says that there was a great blast caused by the dazzle, not from the middle sky but from the earth, which is turned raggedly open. After the bombardment, the situation was very apocalyptic, rendering the people homeless and making their life even worse than animal. Human shadows, dazed and lost, pitched in every direction. This blaze, not risen from the east, smashed in the city's heart, an immense wheel of death's swart sun car spinning down and apart in every direction. Pitched, moved suddenly. Blaze, bright flame or fire, very big and dangerous fire, we can say, smashed, destroyed. An immense wheel of death, a great revolving frame causing death and destruction. So, human shadows, that means people. People are running and here and there to find out the shelter or to rescue themselves from that blast. People and their objects, always, as well as their dwelling places, were dazed and lost and pitched in every direction. This miserable and pathetic plight of the skilled poet, with some beautiful words and diction, images and symbols. In this stanza, the poet takes the image of the bright sun. But the sun here is not the natural sun rising in the eastern sky daily for giving life to the whole world and driving the darkness away from the world. The sun here refers to the man-made sun caused by the powering down of atom bombs. Just like the sun, the atom bomb also emit bright rays, but the rays are not the fruitful rays of the sun giving health and energy to both men and plants. Here the rays engendered by the bombs threshed and butchered the whole humanity within a second. So the phrase right in the city square shadow shows the dropping of the bomb in the middle of the town, generally the center of the people's entertainment and their strolling. In the natural process, the sun generally appears in the east and it slowly and slowly comes over the horizon. But here, in this case, it is just the opposite. The sun here never comes slowly but very speedily, and that too in very middle of the city. Thus here the comparison is very appropriate and interesting. The phrase human shadows is highly suggestive. It shows various layers of meaning. At first, it suggests how human beings of the city were turned to shadows. They are turned to death. Secondly, it stands for the dark shadow of the whole human being who boast of the great civilization and culture. It also suggests the self-centered egomaniac politicians who seldom feel the qualm of conscience in dropping out the bomb on the innocent people. The phrase human shadows also presents a contrast to the natural sun. Generally, when the sun is over our head in the sky, there is a shadow of our body created by the light of the sun. But here the human shadows are dazed and lost. In other words, there were no men, so there were no shadows. The phrase death swart sankar is also very connotative. It connotes how the atomic blast is just like the wheels of the sun causing violent death all over. Instant of a sun's rise and set, with an annihilating flare one compressed noon. This stanza of the poem is even more ironic and thought-provoking. The poet says that during the dance of the death in the middle of the Hiroshima city, the sun rises and sets in a very short time. As a result, all the visions, dreams, and aspirations of human beings were smashed to pieces. In other words, we can say that the terrible blast of the bomb flashed out very suddenly and also subsided in a moment. So both the rising and the setting of the sun were done within a very short period of time. We know that the sun generally rises in the morning and sets in the evening. But here in this city of Hiroshima, this whole process, bomb blast of the sun from morning to evening, were confined to few seconds at noon of the day. This is why the poet uses the phrase one compressed noon. This phrase also shows the cruel and inhuman activity of human being to change the rule of nature. This reminds us of William Wordsworth, a great poet of Romantic school of poetry. And then it was not human shadows that lengthened, paled and died. It was men suddenly become as mist then gone. The shadows stay, burn on rocks, stones of these vacant streets. The extended metaphor of the sun has been again very beautifully used in this stanza, in which the poet says that it was not human shadows that lengthened, paled on, and died. The only shadows that they are the shadows of the burning rocks and stones of these vacant streets. This poetic and metaphoric description present a very realistic picture of that situation caused by the atom bomb. The poet is of the opinion that all men of the city were died as suddenly as the mist. Mist is kohra. In the natural process of the day, the heat of the sun dries the mist on the blades of the grass. But here, this man-made fears and horrible bomb end the life of men within a very few minutes. The only thing that stays in the city is the shadows. Again, here the term shadow, he got a number of meanings. At first, it suggests the dark aspects of that satiric behavior of men. It also indicates the stain and scar made by the merciless mankind towards the innocent mankind. These dark shadows have haunted the civilization and is still haunting and will be haunted in the next generations. So the only thing that stays today is the shadows. On the second scale of meaning, the shadows here also denotes the shadow caused by the flame of the burning rock and stones of the vacant street. Because there were no people life remain in the city. A sun conjured by men converted men to air, to nothing. White shadows signed on the black rock give back man's fitness to himself. This is the last stanza of the poem, and it again extends the image of sun, light and shadow with contrast and irony. In these last lines of the poem, the poet conveys the message to such men who were tempted by the power and authority, fame and popularity. It also shows how it was a great folly of human being to destroy the other human beings. Here, phrases a son doesn't denote the God-made sun made for the welfare of the whole flora and fauna. Here, a sun with indefinite article a and not the definite article the shows the indefinite fate of human being bound to be shattered in the days to come if man keeps on making such type of sons for the annihilation of human being. So it is the message of the poet that such type of sun or bomb conjured by men will do nothing but to convert man to air or to nothingness. The phrase white shadow is very ironic in this context. It suggests the so-called modern materialistic development of modern science, for which men are always breasting and bragging on their achievements. But truly speaking, these white shadows or the modern generation is burning slightly on the black rock made by men. So the witness of this great havoc and tragedy done on the innocent people directly go to the modern man, who is quite insensitive and cold to nature and to his own human brethren. So in the end, we can say horrors of war have been presented in the form of thousands of people killed in an instant. The man-made sun burnt the people and reduced them to ashes, that is, atom bomb. Even the rocks and stones of the vacant streets were burnt, and a mark was left on them as a witness. And The poet has contrasted natural life-giving sun and the man-made death-dealing atom bomb. The poem is written in free verse. This is all in this video. If you have any difficulty, feel free to ask me anything, any question. Thank you very much.